everybody, ChristopherOdd here. Welcome back to XCOM 2. This is Operation Falling Skies. We're literally taking the best of everybody that we possibly can. It's a very difficult mission. We've got 15 enemies out there. We're taking a little bit of everything. We've got rangers, grenadiers, sharpshooters, specialists. We've got EMP bombs. We've got proximity mines. We've got mimic beacons, acid grenades, flashbangs, talon rounds, EMP rounds, dragon rounds. The only thing we're not carrying right now is a newborn baby. And venom rounds, which are pretty much the same thing.
Sky Ranger deployed.
Squad green to deploy.
Recon picked up a transmission from a disabled Advent troop transport that the Resistance locked down in
this
area.
Oh, that looks cool.
The aliens haven't managed to get this thing moving, so we're going in to try and seize whatever materials we can from it. They won't be happy to see us. Eliminate any hostile resistance and secure the area.
Operation Falling Skies in the wilderness of Western U.S. Let's try and do this quickly, quietly, and efficiently. Which I guess would happen if it was quickly and quietly.
The troop transport is nearby. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
All right. So, what I would love to do. This is what I would love to do. Not saying it's gonna happen. What I'd love to do is try and break concealment with the proximity mine comboed with Loxley and her devastating abilities. Let's bring El Frank over. So we're gonna send our two ghosts up. And like I'm kinda, I feel like we could probably get away with going to this car. But I'm gonna go a little further. Seems like that's all good.
Let's do this.
Loxley. Oh, I like this.
Grappling.
We're doing it. Hello. Oh, this is gonna be ridiculous. Oh, this is like primo. This is the best. This is the best. The only thing I'm worried about is like obstacles being in our way, but
good,
we're gonna grab the corner. Let's move Luch in. And let's move Cannibal in.
Bin unterwegs.
I think I heard a turret. I'm hearing a bit more than a turret, actually. Okay, so let's change the pace a bit. We're right near the edge. Sure, I guess this could be like the main road, because this road's cut off. So maybe this is the path that we want to be taking. In which case, she's still in a really good spot for us. There's literally no rush, and we might as well make sure that we can get a good setup. Okay, so far so good. Let's bring him up here.
Hostile targets in sight.
There we go. Wow. Okay, and we got a turret up here. So, remember, we have the dark event happening where there's more enemies on every map, which means, theoretically, more per pod that we find. Which is all really shitty to deal with. It's really not... it's not at all ideal. I think I'm gonna bring Aeneas way up here.
Time to motor.
Bring Andromeda up. Bring Leech up.
Confirmed.
What's over here? Oh, we have an Andromedon too. Hello. That's not good. That's not good. Let's bring Polo over here. Alright, so we have some options. I really would prefer if we could have everybody on Overwatch. Oh god. Oh god. Two codexes. An Andromedon. A bunch of problems over here. Who are actually moving away. So that could be good news. Keep going. Keep going. Go into the darkness. Go into the darkness, little ones. Yes. Yes. This is actually not terrible news because Pius, if we can get him away, which seems like we can do, then we might actually be able to take these guys out, like, quickly. And we could try the ambush tactic that I've wanted to employ.
Closing on target position now.
Let's bring him back. I'm gonna bring Luch up here. We're gonna bring Andromeda over. And then we're gonna bring Cannibal up here to full cover. And here is what we're gonna do. We're gonna overwatch everybody. Overwatch here. Elf rank. We're gonna toss down this mimic beacon, or this proximity mine. These are the best. It does not break concealment. It's like the dirtiest trap that could ever be set. We're gonna overwatch. We're gonna kill zone. And I guess we'll go this way. Ah, this is fine.
Locking them out.
Overwatch.
And then
got it covered.
Here we go. Boom! That's what happens when you move. Did it do nothing to the codexes?
We're visible here.
What? It did nothing to the codexes. That is not what I was expecting. Okay, grazed, of course, because they're impossible to hit. Anybody else? We've lost visual. That's a pretty nice shot.
Enemy destroyed.
Okay, that one could be a bit of a problem. So what's interesting is, like, for some reason the proximity mine didn't do anything to the codexes. I don't know if there's some weird deal. Oh god. Oh god! Man, these Andromedons, I swear, their hit percentage must be 40. Because they never hit. Like, it's not like I can bank on that, but it's like, you know, they just don't. Okay, look at this one here. Lightning hands, I think. Ooh, that one's tempting. But if he splits again, this one's at least a for sure kill if it hits. Wow. 7.
Happy now?
They can dodge a proximity mine, but they take 7 damage from the friggin' pistols. Yeah, they do.
One down,
goodbye. And because of that, we take another pistol shot. Now, I'm thinking that because of his position here, Elf Rank could pretty much just wipe him off the map. Right? Like, his crit chance is pretty good. He's got the better... He's got the, Storm Gun. He's got Dragon Rounds. The only thing that I'm not pumped about is this frickin' turret up here. We also have that Codex to worry about. What are our options? We've got a few. We could chuck a grenade down there to deal with that codex. We could, hey, you know what? Let's try this out. Looch just got the plus 20 to hacking recently, and this could be possible. We're not quite at like god tier level of hacking, but it's getting better. 55%. Let's go for it. Come on! Oh! The worst luck with hacking. Like, obviously I should just stun there, right? Like, I should. It's 100%.
Not getting anywhere.
I should obviously be stunning there, but I got greedy. Okay, how are we gonna handle business here? Elfrink, I'm wondering if we bring you out this way, just to get you away from the turret a bit. It's hard to see if that would. I think we'd be good here.
Moving to position.
Let's see what you can do. Whoa, Jesus. I mean, to be fair, this doesn't really count as a flank on that unit, so imagine if that was a flank shot. That would have been significantly more impressive. All right, we could break concealment with Aeneas if we wanted to. I think we should bring Tom over here to try and kill this thing. We could leave him where he is, but the problem is these codexes are gonna pull that bubbly thing. I'm not stoked about that. Like, so suppressing them is gonna be unnecessary. Nice. Blue screen rounds.
You can't handle me. Running dry.
We could reveal with Aeneas if we want. And then I'm sure he's gonna bubble in here and get all of us, which is fine, we can move. Let's get rid of this one.
What did you expect?
Oh, and he got a promotion. He got promoted from that. That's awesome. That is really, really good. He's our highest ranked ranger, right? So this is good news. Maybe it can kind of separate a bit. That bubble's really big though.
Sure thing.
And I can't see him. Let's move him up here. Let's go for the suppression. Because the last thing I want is for this guy to come out here and take a shot at Loxley, who's standing in the open. He's doing it. Okay, so the teleport doesn't give a shit about suppression. Wasn't sure about that. Believe it or not, we haven't run into that, like, a lot. Alright. So she ended up hitting a couple, which could be way worse. Loxley, you wanna show this codex what's up? Who gives a shit if she dodges, right? Oh, and it did dodge, too. Doesn't matter.
Okay, so I got one.
Really doesn't matter. Yeah, that didn't hit Pius, so that's good.
Concealed.
I'm gonna reconceal. And we're gonna start hunting once again. That gives us vision there. Andromeda will pull back. We know we have a group up there that's pretty large and in charge. Let's see, can we, yeah, anywhere else other than this, we're getting hit. I think we'd be okay there, it's kind of tough to tell. I think we'll just pull back here, we can stand in the open, not be too worried about it.
ready to rock.
Let's, should we take our reload here? I don't think we need to.
Moving to Overwatch.
Good to go.
Save the fire shots.
All right, classic Loxley, super heavy turret, four pieces of armor. We're just gonna destroy this thing from afar. There was a time a while back, I think it was at the black site, when she shot at a turret and she missed. And what she actually ended up doing was blowing out the ground from underneath it. And when that happens, it disables the turret. That was totally, like, that was the best turret kill I've ever seen. And totally unintentional. I do not want to break concealment here. Here we go, this is good. Damn, that looked pretty on point, Polo. I'd be pissed if I were you. So here's four. Centurion, what is that guy? Just an advanced trooper, I think. Couple advanced troopers. Oh, and a shield bearer. Great. At least they're shooting at the right target, in my opinion. Yes. Luch and his stupid haircut. He's just doing work, though. Oh, God. This is not cool. This is not cool. Oh, Jesus. All right.
Target still up.
We got a bit of a puzzle here. One, two, this is not going to be easy by any stretch of the imagination. We do have kill zone back up, so more than likely that's what we should do. We could get in there and skulljack or skull mine. But you know what? Since we have such a good shot on the Centurion, I think that's our first go. Crits. Beautiful. Now just a little tappy tap.
That armor's tough.
Let's go, Luch. Wow. Okay.
Target neutralized.
His last few missions, I gotta say, Luch has been, like, he hasn't been bad, don't get me wrong, like, at all. He's been great. But, there's certainly been a few times where you're like, oh, that's it, you know? Alright, where can I take this? You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking we bring him right over here. Get the full cover. There could be enemies inside, which would be not cool. We could also go here. We could even go here and still have a shot on the Centurion, but this is a much better attempt, I would say. It puts him in range of a lot, and we would have to rely on Aeneas and the Mimic Beacon. So that's something that we'd have to consider if that's what we want. So Tommy's got decent shot, like a decent grenade here. We could try and take out the shield bearer, at least start the process. If I moved up a bit, I don't think we could hit all three. Let's start here. Come on, Tommy. Nice job. Cannibal, we've got the acid if we want it. Not sure that we need to use it. The other thing we could do is, like, I could get... Like, I could bring Aeneas over here. He would still be in concealment, providing us vision. Yeah, I'm not sure. We might... We could flashbang almost everybody. We could flashbang the four that matter. I don't think the turret takes any damage from the flashbang. It would do two damage because of the volatile mix. And, like, I'm thinking Loxley, we pretty much have to lay this down. Right? I'm pretty sure this is what we should do here.
Area on lockdown.
It's just a matter of, do we want to throw the mimic beacon? Because I could also, I'm thinking about moving Aeneas up here to this area. Oh no! Shit! Well, fuck. There goes that idea. That was really unfortunate that just went down the way it did. Like, really unfortunate that went down the way it did. Okay. Oops. Because what I wanted to do was move John in here so that I can move Elfrank up and potentially, probably just kill this guy outright. Now, I can move him in here. And I guess cover-wise, it's pretty similar. We're not going to get the full cover benefit from this side as much, I don't think. Maybe we would. Because the other option is we try and flashbang these four instead and forget the shield bearer, right? Kind of depends on what Infernal can do. For some reason, the turret's what worries me the most, when maybe I shouldn't even worry about that as much. Could take the tree. I'm just trying to figure out what the best plan is for Elfrank here, and I'm not convinced that I have one. I think I'm gonna move him in there. Flashbang. I'm not sure who I'm gonna flashbang yet.
Moving out.
It'll depend if we can erase this muton from existence or not. We got a good chance. Oh fuck, he survived. Oh my god. But so, yeah, he's gonna burn. So that's a good sign. That means we can focus our efforts over here. Like so. Flashbang that group and see what happens. We did get a little bit of damage on the turret. That's cool. So he's down. These guys are going to be a little bit confused. Loxley, where's your shot? Damn it. He only moved a little bit, so I can understand that. He got away. No shots. What a dick. And no shots from Loxley? What? What is happening here? Damn it.
Incoming fire. About to get burned to a crisp.
What happened there, Loxley? I'm guessing it's because of these trees. I'm guessing that's what's caused a bit of an issue here. This is not very cool. We've got this guy on Overwatch. Oh, you know what? I have an idea. Here's what we're gonna do. We could skull mine. It's actually not a bad idea. Where would we position ourselves? We'd be in half cover. This guy is a bit of a problem. That's something I wouldn't mind dealing with. I don't really want to waste an acid bomb on him. But I mean, like, I could. Just to remove the Overwatch. The other option is we could combat protocol. Where is he? We could combat protocol, but then we won't have enough moves to try the skull mine. So I'm thinking we just take the acid shot here. Should we? Yeah, let's go for it. That's gonna let us get Andromeda in here, disable this turret, kill the Viper, hopefully. Okay, so let's bring the Skull Mine in here. Oh, there's our buddy. There we go. Minor cache of intel, or information leading to the location of an alien facility. We could keep going on the intel thing. If we fail, we'll take some damage, which sucks. Let's take the intel. Oh, never mind. Okay. That worked out perfectly. That's two misclicks that
could be something we could use
cost
here.
Me. Stock and advanced conditioning. Nice. Plus 3 HP. Typically it's 2, but it's because we have the PCS increased thing from the Guerrilla Tactics, right? Now, can she... She can't see any of these. It's these trees. That's the problem here. Alright, Tommy. Where can I bring you? I can bring you up enough to be able to hit both of those, I think. We're 1, 2, 3, 4 tiles away. Maybe close, that's for sure.
Let's move already.
I don't know if we're gonna be able to, actually. Yep, we can. Let's go for it. There we go. Turret's down.
Menace 1-5. Watch those supply crates. If you destroy them,
oh, did we hit a supply crate?
For us to recover once the area is secure.
Oh, damn it. That's not cool. If we're not gonna move, I'm a little bit concerned about the fire spreading, but let's reload and then take our shot.
Ready to go.
Jesus. 18 damage. These Rangers, man, are just insane. Alright, what else? We've got Loxley, but I mean... Not a lot that she can do from up here. Unfortunately, because it's such a great spot. It's an amazing position. It's just these trees.
All right, I'll go.
And I don't really want to toss a mimic beacon here. But at the same time, maybe I should.
Confirm.
Let's run back here for now. bring her up top. It's not really gonna get us a whole lot.
On Overwatch.
And the other, only other option is bring in the grenade. Or use the grenade or use the beacon. These guys all have pretty good cover. I'm a bit concerned that this guy might be carrying a grenade on him. Although I can't see it. That's a good sign. Let me bring Aeneas over here.
Copy that.
And our guys are just gonna have to be cool for a second. Everybody just be cool. Yeah, that acid, that sucks. Hey, pal. Oh, no.
Admin troops here.
Well, actually, in a way, I'm kind of relieved because that means we still have the Mimic Beacon. This guy's moving into a questionable spot. Oh, shit! Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Wow, nice shot. Holy nutsack. Wow.
I'm taking fire!
Oh my god. Looch, dude. Whoa. Like, whoa. Like, whoa. Yeah, we could go up here in half cover. I think this is probably better. Let's bring Elfrank over. Evaporated.
Enemy eliminated.
We've got the EMP bomb. He also has blue screen rounds. Chances to hit the mech are pretty good. EMP bomb's guaranteed, lowers his tech score, which means we could probably hack it easier. Let's go for it. Well, damage now, Jesus. And he's down for two turns. Well, that'll work. Those things are so good. Like, ridiculous. Maybe we just drop more acid on these guys. Actually wouldn't mind getting the guy in the back, to be totally honest. Let's see, if we're up here. Whoops. Let's check out what the hacking's like. I just want to get to the point where we can take control of things consistently, but we're just not there yet. And even though this guy's, like, taking control is not going to help us here. Okay, so 55%. We could also re-stun it to make a successful hack for loot, which we should probably do. But we have two turns. Pius, I think this is your moment, pal. I really believe this is the time to come alive. Show these guys what's going on. We're gonna be spotted regardless. We just need to flank this guy.
Heading out. I've been spotted.
Okay, John. Just like we practiced, pal. Good job.
That's right.
Okay, and now we have to kill this guy. So, what are my options? I can get right in there. It's not a bad option. Good combat protocol. I think just getting right in there with Looch is probably fine. We're not gonna have flush.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Come on. Good job.
Kill confirmed. Negative ammo. I'm spent.
Ist das auch sicher?
We could just keep Elfrank there.
Deploying grapple.
Bring Loxley up.
It is clear.
Hey, that's good.
Deflection.
We don't want to kill him. 5, 6, 7, 8. Chances are slim but possible that that happens, so we're gonna hunker her down for a second. Reload here. Reload here. Actually, we can't. Bring John back a bit.
Moving to designated coordinates.
I'm hoping this is our last guy. My gut's telling me that it is. Okay, let's actually reload first. Take the haywire. One thing I'm not using enough is scanning protocol. Oh, remember too, we should have Faceless on this mission, so this is probably not the last one. Let's just take the guarantee just to keep working on our hacking.
We're in.
I need a medkit here.
Wait.
What? The fuck just happened there? Whoa. Why is he bleeding out? Is that from the feedback? And if so, he didn't hit him last turn. I don't know what that was. That's goddamn questionable, if you ask me.
That arm is tough.
That is questionable.
Was ist da drüben?
We got 4 turns to find a potential faceless here. Oh, damn it, Polo. Things are unraveling rather quickly, aren't they?
Closing on target position now.
Let's just get these guys in. I'd love to get the kill with Polo. He's the one that needs a little bit of promoting.
Let's rock. Come get some.
Now, another thing we can do is we can pick him up and we can evac out of here with one of them if we want. Come on, Polo. There it is.
It is here.
Munitionist Knapp!
Alright, now, the thing is Luch is not available to scan for faceless.
Absolutely.
Which means we're gonna have to frickin' find it. And I'm not really digging that.
Moving to designated position.
Oh, here we go.
That's a map in here.
Oh, Jesus. There's like a shitload still. Well, this is not cool. This is really terrible. Man. I think we're gonna have to kill zone this.
Lockdown confirmed.
What else do we have? We've got the beacon. We've got the beacon. The thing is they cannot see the beacon very well from here. We can distract at least two, I think. We gotta go for that. Okay, we're gonna suppress this one.
Suppressing fire on target.
And then I'm thinking we pull back. Pull L Frank back. Wait for the Overwatch to come in.
Going in for the kill. Moving out.
Okay, there's the Overwatch we need. It's a good shot. Oh, no shot from L. Frank. There it is. Damn it. I'm like on a roller coaster of emotions.
I got nothing.
This entire time.
Watch the flanks.
We've still gotta get Looch out of here. Like, this is not a good scenario that we're in. I should be, because of the shadow chamber, I should be counting how many enemies run into so I know exactly what to expect. Are you serious? Oh my god, this dude. John? Duck, John! Wow. Heavy injuries. He's got two more turns to bleed out, and that's not good. I think we gotta launch the acid bomb here. Maybe what we do, let's see. Let's boost the crit chances here. And then let's launch the acid bomb.
Then dash.
Okay. I'm pretty sure we can just wipe this guy out. Oh, fuck me. The dodge? Are you kidding me?
We can't.
Oh, my god. That's what you get, I guess. Which now means I gotta take the shot with Loxley over there. But I'm really worried about being in sight of those others. So I think I'm gonna bring her down here, flank this guy, take the pistol shot instead. Alright.
There you go.
These dodges, wow. Just when you start to count on it, like, it's like, well, you can pretty much have unlimited kills whenever you want them. Nope. I'm gonna bring L. Frank back. And let's see if Tommy... Oh, should we suppress him? Because I kind of want to keep him pinned. Because really what I should have done is I should have moved Pius. This is actually not a great spot for him. I think I'm going to go for the suppression to try to keep the officer here.
Let's do this.
Blasting that target.
Oh my god, that's a lot of damage. he gonna take any? Little bit. He's marking Polo, who's sitting there out in the open. Oh my god, look at how many injuries we're taking. What is the shield bearer gonna do? Okay. Okay, here's what we're doing. We are going to place the evac zone right here. Okay. Polo. We're gonna grab Looch.
It's finished, we're done.
And we are gonna get the fuck out of here. Actually, maybe before we do that, we have two actions left, right? This is gonna use one. Let's focus on the officer, and then let's leave. Nick of time. I don't know what that means, but okay. Oh, interesting! Oh, so he's no longer marked. Oh, that's kind of, I mean, that's cool. Like, I get that. I think that's smart. I thought we figured something out there. Guess not. Okay, can we see him from up here is the question. Not the one we want, fortunately. Come on. We need you, Loxley. Shit.
Not good.
No, you're right. Not good. Not good at all. All right, let's bring John in. Can't hit both. We gotta get rid of that shield. That puts him in the open. If Tom can hit this, then I think we're okay. Cause then I can bring Infernal in, flank this guy, kill him.
I'm ready.
Come on, Tom. There it is, buddy. Eat shit.
Whoa! You see that?
Hit it there now.
Let's bring Danny Boy in. Come on, Danny Boy! Oh! 19. Now.
Target neutralized. Draining ammo.
Status confirmed.
Oh, shit.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission
there we
accomplished.
Go. I thought we had a faceless, but maybe it's only on certain mission types or something. Okay, that was rough. That was really rough. There was a couple of things that I did incorrectly for sure. A couple of misclicks that put us in really bad scenarios. But, man, lots of enemies. I'm gonna start counting. If the Shadow Chamber's gonna tell us that information, I'm gonna start using it better. But, we got everybody out. Some of our top guys are going to be out for a while. That's really going to hurt us, but it'll give some other guys opportunities to step up. which isn't always such a bad thing. Alright. Pius got promoted. Oh! Oh, that is interesting. So he's got hail of bullets, which means it's going to be guaranteed to hit the target, but I think it uses, what, three ammo? I think it uses three. Which isn't so bad if we need to guarantee a shot. Plus, because he can, if we're flanking somebody from far away, we could guarantee a kill. Definitely going to grab Untouchable. If you get a kill during your last turn, then the next attack against you misses guaranteed. But these guys are out for a while. Looch, of all people, not gravely wounded. Not sure how that worked out. Some supplies. This is not ideal. The situation that we've just put ourselves into. So, Alien Infiltrator, I'm pretty sure... Battleship. Doesn't say... Will it show us here? No. I'm pretty sure Alien Infiltrator, though, is faceless. We did not have a faceless there, so... Maybe it's only on certain types? Certain mission types?
Avenger plotting new course.
But those guys are out for a while. Should actually check.
Commander, I appreciate you recruiting new staff for the engineering team, but as it stands,
okay.
We have people still waiting for an assignment. We can have them working
could
on construction, excavation, or staffing a facility.
Hey, Commander.
Why do I have engineers not doing anything? Why is Sinclair... What did we just finish? Why do we have a free engineer here? And how long have we had him free? We can start in the power coil, I suppose.
Pickings are slim, but I'm hoping we find a few more recruits who can handle a wrench. I could use the help.
We could try and grab some of these. Got a little bit of money. Biggest booms wouldn't be that terrible, would it? It's pretty pricey. Let's grab this stuff if we need to. Let's see what happens before we make any hasty decisions. Okay, more venom rounds. I think we should get into a different line of business here with the proving ground. Let's grab some more experimental grenades.
Sounds good, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
We're gonna have the Psylab soon. That'll be cool. 2 days. Supply drop in 1 day.
Incoming message for you, Commander. Patching it through to your.
It's a lot of money.
Your
progress. Look, we're getting majors now.
The aliens over the past month has been
Beagle Rush
significant,
showed up.
Commander. But there is still room to improve if we are going to eliminate the alien threat.
So, Major John Beagle Rush Teasdale and Major Findus Lowenzon. All right. We're gonna get a retaliation mission now. New construction, reduce the alien facility counter. Look at that. That'll be instant if that happens. Then we have the hidden one. I hate to waste it on hidden events. Let's see. Should we try for these alloys? Like, is this really our top priority? I don't even know that it is, to be honest. You get us like 50-60 alloys, which is fine. But we could probably use the supplies sooner. So I'm gonna head over there.
Avenger plotting new course.
Come on, Psylab. There we go. Here we go. It's been a long time coming. A strong Psy operative could really help us out. So let's throw an engineer in here, Lazaro. And we're gonna throw in Sebastian the Hammer Zawadzki. We've been saving him for the Psy Lab. He's finally going in. Let's see, how long is he in there for? 13 days, Jesus Christ. Okay.
Setting course for Mexico.
Let's go take a look at the black market and our home base.
Welcome, Commander.
So, we've got Beagle. If we want a Ranger, or we can get a sharpshooter major. Being told stories about evil overworlds. Think evil overworlds? By his grandmother, Gudrun, Findus didn't hesitate much when he heard about the new recruitment wave for the XCOM project. Although he's not that fancy of a man, he really likes green. What? He wants to save the world while following a smart commander. I don't know if this squad is for you, my friend. As much as I would like to have you. I mean, if we were going to recruit somebody, this would be the time when everybody's hurting.
Avenger plotting new course.
Market is open.
Okay, look at this. So, superior expanded mag, superior scope, beam cannon, powered armor. Oh, that would be so good. 215 intel. The thing is, our next research project, I think it's got to be the Codex. So, I will go ahead and buy a scope. The stock's not bad. Expanded mag is really good. We could put this on Aeneas if we wanted to. With his new hail of bullets. But I don't know if that's totally necessary. This is the most tempting, but it's too expensive. Like, we can't afford to be doing that. Expanded mag. I gotta say though, a superior stock could come in pretty handy. A lot of times. Like, how many times have we had an enemy with, like, 3 health? Quite a few. I'm gonna hold off. As much as I really would like to, I'm gonna hold off. Viper corpses, you can take a few of those. And actually, they can take a gas bomb from me. If they're willing to pay for it. Let's get the relay up. Let's start making contact. Because this is going to start to tick soon. We're going to have the retaliation mission probably within seconds. Skinner's back. Looch is back. There it is. Okay. 15 enemies with an unknown enemy type. What could that frickin' be? Operation Haunting Pyre.
Setting course for Mexico.
And let's see. Loxley's in. Skinner's in. Let's get you the medkit right away. Let's get the plasma rifles up and running. Here we go. This is gonna be good. We haven't had enough because it's 500 supplies, but we finally have some money. There it is. Let's see, what else? We've got the battle scanner if we want it, but Skinner's got the, oh no, that's not him. Battle scanner could be useful here. Let's see. Looch is definitely coming out. Flashbang. Andromeda is coming. Do we need an EMP? Elfrank. And we could bring our gunslinger out. He's not, like, fully, you know, developed yet, but that's the other thing I should have been doing is changing this exosuit around. Let's see. He's got new slots here. I'm thinking, let's give him the stock. Because, like, his aim is not the greatest. He's very defensive. But in the right scenario, that guaranteed 3 damage could be good. So let's do that. Who else here? Elfrank doesn't have anything now since we upgraded. Oh, he's got the laser sight. That's true. We could give him expanded mag. Give him the free reload. Let's give him the free reload. Who else here? Looch, he's got the advanced repeater. That's been working out pretty well. The scope's been working out pretty well, so we're gonna leave that. What does Tommy have? We've got the aim, superior perception, we've got the will, and we've got additional health. Let's see. Maybe Pullman, we were gonna give him this aim, weren't we? Because he's got, currently, he's got the dodge or something. Advanced agility. Yeah, we're gonna switch that out for aim for him. And then the weapon slot, like, I really don't, like, I don't really care about that too much. Because we're going to be using his pistol, but let's give him the stock so that if we need the 2 damage, we can guarantee it with his rifle. And then who could we give health to? We could give it to Infernal, but he's got the speed. Don't really want to replace that. Looch has the aim. And he's got speed as well. I think we'll just hold on to it for now. This should be good. Yeah, we'll start off in concealment with Elfrank, so we could still do the proximity mine into the kill zone with Loxley, and we'll just go from there. All right. Wish me luck, guys. One thing I'll do before we go again is I'll check the Shadow Chamber details and see if we need to bring that EMP grenade or not. But, yeah. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.